Hi everybody, Lindsay here, lead programmer of Party Golf, and welcome to one of the ways to play Party Golf. I've got Adam and Ben here with me, and this time round, we're going to show off the default game mode of Party Golf. So we're not going to play with any of our hundreds of settings, we're just going to play vanilla Party Golf. This is the same as pressing quick game, and we'll just do that now actually, we'll play quick game. If you haven't seen Party Golf before, you use left stick to aim and X to shoot. Simple controls as we could have come up with. And you can do little shots by not pushing the stick all the way to the edge. Let's get straight into it.
A lot of people often comment that they expect it to be one of those, you hold a direction and then you hold to get power.
Nope.
It's not that way.
We find that this way we're able to adjust our power a lot quicker, because if you're sitting there waiting to get max shot power, then you have a bit of time guaranteed before each shot. That sort of thing.
Very much a conscious decision. We wanted people to be able to shoot whenever they were able to shoot and not potentially lose a shot.
Yeah, because I think part of that is that we're all shooting at the same time. If we were a turn-based game, then that would be a perfectly valid way of adjusting your power. We'll point out that we do have a turn-based mode in this, but it doesn't change the way that you shoot. And it actually comes out a little bit more fun, a little bit faster. So the default mode we're looking at here, we're normal shape, normal ball sizes, and we're just circles, so obviously we roll. I'm doing really poorly at this mode, I don't know what's going on here.
That was an easy shot, there were two easy shots to make that you just decided, yes, I'm going to become very familiar with the terrain.
Party Golf's an easy game to play, and as you guys just showed out there, there is a plus 10 for getting a hole-in-one by default.
I do believe, lads, that the AI is trouncing us.
Yes. We've only got three of us here, so purple, wow, what a shot, is an AI.
You know, I should just stop trash talking. I'm the blue ball, by the way. Very comfortably in last place.
Usually Ben, our yellow ball, does a lot worse than this. I'm not sure what's going on.
You like to say that, but I've yet to see any evidence.
Well, I can tell you what the evidence is, Ben. If any of our players look at our 4 hours of video in the game, the purple ball who does poorly in every tutorial video is Ben.
But every single just lost?
Me, to the AI, yes. So one of the features of Party Golf is trash talking, as which we've just shown off. The other default settings we're looking at there is, part of the reason why some of us aren't syncing, getting a chance to sync, is that by default you get 10 seconds after the first person has gone in. To get in as well. There's no penalty for not getting in, but for the people who don't get in, it's down to whoever's closest, rather than whoever was first in. This keeps around snappy.
So the goal of the default game mode is to get to 500 first, with the score increments being 100 to first place, 50 to second, 20 to third, and 10 to fourth.
The reason we mention that is because you can customize that quite easily in our settings as well. A round goes for 60 seconds, I think, by default.
Unless someone sinks.
That's right. That's right. You've got 60 seconds to get in. And trust me, it does happen that no one sinks.
For people who was just paying attention to what I did, I actually went off screen for a brief second and managed to shoot back on. There is a small grace period in which you are not immediately sent back to the start when you go off screen.
Yep.
This is also customizable.
Match point. Well, yellow there, so yeah, he's very close to 500.
With some pretty trails to indicate that he's on match point.
Ah, well pointed out.
Think I've got this.
I think he's done it. I think he's just ahead of everyone. The AI was... Oh, thank you very much for that.
This is a very disappointing video for me. Very nicely done there, Ben.
That's what happens when you keep telling me that I'm
awful. Running away with it. Well, there you go.
Alright, so what you can do is, obviously we have a lot of game modes that you can mess around with settings that we've chosen, and we have our custom game screen. But even from our default mode, we're so big fans of customization that on this default screen, you can do a couple of common customizations that you might want to do. You can add power-ups, which is a whole video on all of our different power-ups. We have force fields and aftertouch and spin, many things there. But you can also change what it means to win, so maybe least shots instead of quickest time, the time limit for the round, do you explode when you hit each other or do you pass through each other, what happens when you hit the edge of the screen, whether or not you want to be playing with AI, so at the moment if I turned off the AI there'd only be three of us, or turn on our awesome voting mode, so check out that video as well. What I'm going to do here in this one is set it, give us a turbo, so I can show just how easy it is to customize just from default. So we should have turbo on now. Here it is. To use any of the power-ups in Party Golf by default, it's the square button. And this one, we just hold it down and you go faster. A really simple one to illustrate. And a great level for it. I love mountains and turbo. Oh, I did poorly.
Yellow is, again, trouncing us.
Showing you how it is done.
And no power-up, no turbo will save me there. So, back to the start for me.
Yep. We have a default shooting mode as well, where you can shoot again when you're moving slowly. But we have other options for that, like after a bounce. Always shooting, so you can shoot in midair. And shot clock sort of thing, where you're forced into a shot every second. Or any number of seconds as well. Can't say the word customization enough in this video. We'll do a few more rounds of this one. Yeah, shoot for the sky. You see, yeah, you
can in and out.
Yeah, you can see that I bounced in and out of the hole there. That's a house rule that we've got in Party Golf. Oh, I love that. I love the interaction that you still get, even with the vanilla Party Golf experience. And this basically, so if you don't know the story of Party Golf, we actually made this game in 48 hours originally. We have spent a year on it after that, we'll point out. But the original prototype was done in 48 hours, and so it didn't have any of the fancy bells and whistles that you see today in Party Golf. But it was very similar to this. A lot slower, because we didn't realize just how awesome the game is in a faster motion.
I believe we literally just upped the speed by 25%.
25%?
At a
yep.
point.
It was one.
Seems
to,
about right.
Yep. So if you ever see the original Oya trailers for Party Golf, you can see the original speed, except for where I've edited it to be fast speed. These videos that you're looking at today, there's no editing involved here, where we are just at the fast speed. Look at that! I love that shot.
I feel robbed.
Yellow's on match point here. So we're into the ground. Was that a win there, Ben?
It was.
That was a win. So I'll wrap up this video here. Hope you've enjoyed looking at how you can just play the default version of Party Golf. And we just customized it with one way with a turbo there. I won't wrap it up. I'm getting the nod from Adam here that I was going to show one other thing, which is just to have a look at some of the default settings in the menu. So by default, I'm going to go through all these different categories, but by default we're golf balls, as you quite clearly saw. By default there's no power up, but we just added turbo quite easily. Scoring is quickest instead of something like least shots or most bounces, shortest path. A lot of fun different ones there. The terrain is quite normal, but you can, it's still random each time. You can customize it to be in caves all the time. We didn't even see any caves in those ones, I don't think, did we? Caves are quite rare because they're a lot harder. The tees are kind of standard of tees on the left and the holes on the right. And we'll point out with the terrain that you can have a scrolling terrain. We didn't do that by default because it makes shorter rounds as well. Then we have a whole heap of other categories that by default are also turned off. So checkpoints, make sure you check out the video of that. It's my favourite feature in Party Golf, where you have to go through different checkpoints before you can get in there. We got no water by default, but you can add that. There's no coins, no mines or anything like that, but they're a lot of fun. By default, you'll respawn when you go off the edge instead of bouncing. You can turn on bouncy sides if some people are struggling, and you can do that per player, I'll point out. So say Ben was really bad at the game, which he wasn't, but we might want to turn on a per player screen edge for him. There's no sky junk. After death doesn't come into it on here because there's no way of dying in the default mode, but there are ways to mess with people after you die. Everyone's shooting at the same time instead of the turn-based thing that I was talking about. The shooting rules that I was talking about where you can shoot while moving slowly. Round rules, 10 seconds after shooting, after sinking. Playing to 500 instead of maybe an infinitely long match. You can have no limit at all if you want. No voting, no Rat King, no Night Golf, having reversed controls is the other option you can do there with aiming, but we didn't do that clearly because we weren't screaming. Default close to earth options there with the gravity and the speed of the game, but you can make it faster or something like that, and the AI are on. You can also change the personalities, in air quotes, of the AI to be angry or twitchy or that sort of thing as well. They can play in different styles. Angry ones shoot at you all the time, they're kind of fun. But those are the default settings that we just played with there, which are quite fun, and that's the reason why we've chosen the default mode, but at the same time are very playable for people. Yeah, but as you can see, lots of customization. This is just the superficial level. Remember, at any other level, you can change four other things, but you don't have to. And you don't even have to use this menu. You can just use our game modes. There's enough content here, even in the basic modes thing, without even having to go into any of the other categories. But we hope that you will explore that. And we hope that you'll explore some of the other videos on this channel that show how the different ways that you can play Party Golf. Thanks for watching.